Yeah, guys, I don't know what he's doing up this shallow, but I came up to the north end just because the water temps were a little bit warmer the last time I was out here, and I caught a lot more bites. He's the wrong color, but he sure fought pretty hard. I got the gold underspin on today. It's real overcast, water's pretty murky. Gold underspin, first taker. We're just gonna fish some different territory today. I'm tired of hitting all the same spots here, so gonna explore some new stuff today. Hopefully it's productive, but we'll see. Nice white bass. Fatty. Ooh. Guys, what is that? Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh my god. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. So that's the third bite that I've had at that same spot. So in this end of the lake, a lot of people have their own boat ramps that come down into the water, and I've got three bites right on the edge of that boat ramp as I let my underspin come down. The first two were white bass, I think. The second one might not have been, but check out what the third bite was, boys. Golly. Freaking another 5 or 6 pounder, dude. Oh my gosh. Dude, this is a tank. I knew that underspin was gonna get me some big fish. I was calling it. I hope I can get some more bites today, but the wind's really picking up and the water temps are down to 47, guys. It was like in the high 20s the last two nights. So I really didn't know what to expect, but I wanted to come back up and fish some stuff I've never fished before here, and I'm real glad that we made that choice. Looky there, pretty much 5 pounds even, guys. It's bouncing between 415 and 503. The wind's real rough, so I can't get a steady reading, but he's eating too, man. He's got something down his gullet. It's opened up. She gave me a heck of a fight. Let's go. She's gonna be making some big little bass here in the near future too. Go get to it. She might have been scoping out some spots. You won't be able to see the fish swimming off too well up here because it's pretty dang murky. But that's just crazy, right? 47 degree murky water and that fish was in 8 foot. If you can see, there's their boat ramp and it comes down into the water and it stops about right here. And I was casting to the corner and just working it down the side. and I was almost dragging that little underspin on the bottom, popping it a little bit, and that thing, I thought I was snagged on the side of the boat ramp, but it started moving and I was like, here we go. So I just changed my angle. Instead of parallel on that boat ramp, I just cast across it. I mean, that's not the kind of bass that I'm really trying to catch, but that thing is chunked. That is a chunk of a white bass. He'd make a nice lunch, but you get to live to see another day, buddy. Later. Could have been three white bass, could have been a little dinner there. Boys, what is that? What is that? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Huge, whatever this is. I'm just chasing him with my trolling motor. Still haven't seen it yet. I'm literally like rodeoing him, like corralling him to keep him between these two docks. Because he can't go down. He's only in 2 feet of water, so he's just got to run sideways. We're literally just doing circles like I'm riding a bull right now. You gotta get tired sometimes. We're literally just doing circles. It's like we're gonna be slimy today, guys. Oh man. Not ideally what I like to catch, but what are you gonna do? He's got a piece of his tail missing too. Alright. Say bye to Mr. Buffalo. Oh my god. My goodness, look at the size of that white bass. That is a monster white bass, y'all. This is pretty fun. This is exactly the kind of thing I love doing. Like, being kayaks are pretty much the only thing that can do this, just getting on this shallow, rocky, sandy bank and just drifting under all these docks and fish all of this shallow rock and little pieces of cover along the bank. Good lord! What have they been eating? He's not near as big as the last one, but he's fat. I can tell you one thing, man. These things slam your bait. If you want to do something fun, tie on an underspin on 6-pound test, go find you some big white bass and just buckle up and get ready for some fights, because these things will give them to you. Good night. He felt like a bass for that reason. Jiminy Christmas, these things are huge. These things are stacked. They're so stacked. man, guys, it's getting really windy out here. Super windy. The water temp is 48. And I just caught him in a foot of water. Crazy. That might be a better one, guys. Yeah, that's a better fish. Oh my god, I don't think the camera got that. Dude, that white bass just went airborne. Oh, what a stud, dude. This white bass, I hooked him and he went up in the air just like a largemouth. He shot out like a rocket. There was a couple largemouth mixed in, but it's just been all these magnum white bass. Good night. That is huge. I can't come fish here without fishing the spot, guys. I'm sorry. Close to home and it's just convenient. Typically always a bass or two to be had here. Still on the underspin. So that's gonna do it for that trip, guys. Tried to fish all new areas. I hadn't fished most all of those spots where I caught all those white bass and those few bass. And the crazy part was, I'm not yanking y'all's chain either. 47.9 degree water, guys. I caught all my fish in 1 to 2 feet of water. Some of them were even in less than a foot of water. Pretty good stain in that water too. So like everything you always hear, you know, oh, cold, muddy water, don't even bother kind of thing. Well, I put on that gold blade underspin and a Sixth Sense Divine swim bait on it and just went to work, covered a bunch of water, and it paid off, man. Some of those white bass just slammed me. It was a ton of fun. And we ended up with a big bass, guys. Got a 5-pounder again. I caught all those fish on my Cast King Zephyr 6-pound fluoro and the Dalvin Sierra 740C. So, had a blast. As always, thanks for watching. Y'all take her easy, and we'll see you on the next one.